Explore the Fuji electric solution, how to combine Monitouch HMI and FRENIC drives. Let's take a look to the agenda. As the first topic, I will make a short product introduction about the Technoshot Smart HMI and the FRENIC-Ace. After that, I'm going to show you an application examples and we will see a few applications where Technoshot and FRENIC-Ace can be used together. Third, I'm going to show you how to communicate Technoshot and FRENIC-Ace. So we are going to see communication options, wiring and communication ports, communication settings, FRENIC-Ace parameter descriptions, description in BS56, FRENIC-Ace communication parameters, how to read and write drive parameters from the HMI, and the FRENIC-Ace component part. Let's start with a short product introduction. Technoshot Smart is a Monitouch HMI and it is available in two sizes, 7 inches and 10 inches. It has widescreen and WVGA resolution. 3 serial ports are included and also an Ethernet ports in the model with the letter I in the code, like the TS1070SI. The Technoshot Smart models also include special functions like the VNC server and the FTP server. The VNC server allows us to connect a PC, a smartphone or a tablet to the HMI and to control the process remotely. The FTP server allows us to exchange files like CSV files between an FTP client installed in a PC. Time to see the FRENIC-Ace. The FRENIC-Ace is a high-performance drive designed to suit a wide variety of applications. The FRENIC-Ace offers advanced integration capabilities, including applied power rating, sensorless dynamic torque vector control, permanent magnet synchronous motor control, 2 channels onboard serial port, communication ports, and the customer customizable logic. The FRENIC-Ace also includes the safety function STO and it's available up to 220 kW, rated in height heavy duty. Some application examples. By combining the Technoshot Smart and the FRENIC-Ace drive, and thanks to its features, it is possible to solve many kinds of applications. As you can see in the slide, this application can be industrial washing machines, winder machines, professional mixers, fans, or solar pumping applications. Also, many other applications can be solved with the combination of Technoshot Smart and FRENIC-Ace. And in some of these applications, it's possible even to avoid the use of a PLC thanks to the FRENIC-Ace customizable logic and the powerful macro commands of the Technoshot Smart. In my opinion, this combination of the FRENIC-Ace and the Technoshot Smart is quite powerful, as we can solve many applications, even without using a PLC. How to communicate a TS Smart and the FRENIC-Ace? First of all, I would like to say that all Monitouch HMI models can communicate with all the FRENIC drives. But today we are going to focus in the communication between the TS Smart and the FRENIC-Ace inverter. So, which are the available communication options? We have Modbus RTU and Modbus TCP. Modbus RTU is a serial-based protocol and up to 31 inverters can be connected with no extra hardware. On the other hand, Modbus TCP is an Ethernet-based protocol and up to 64 inverters can be connected. But in this case, we need the optional communication board OPC-PRT installed in the inverter. Okay, now let's see the communication ports of the Technoshot Smart. As I said before, the Technoshot Smart has 3 serial ports. COM1, which is located in the bottom of the backside, and the COMs 2 and 3, which are close to the COM1, also in the backside of the Technoshot Smart. As you can see, COM2 and COM3 are physically in the same connector. So if we want to use these two ports, we have to combine the wiring in the same connector. And finally, the Ethernet port, which is also available is available in the models with the I in the code, and is also very close to the COM2 and 3 in the backside of the TechnoShot. Let's check now the FRENIC-Ace communication ports. The FRENIC-Ace has two communication ports. Port 1 is located under the keyboard, and the port 2 is located close to the terminal board. Both ports are serial ports and can be used for Modbus communication. Then, seeing the available ports, few combinations are possible where choosing them to communicate these both devices in Modbus RTU. Therefore, we can choose either COM1 or COM3 in TechnoShot and port 1 or port 2 in the FRENIC-Ace inverter. Here you can see the four combinations of these ports. On the other hand, for Modbus TCP, it's needed to install the OPC PRT board in the inverter, and connecting the TechnoShot and the OPC PRT with an Ethernet cable. Remember that only TS models with an I in the code have the Ethernet port. You may wonder about the wiring diagrams. So all the wiring diagrams are available in the TechnoShot connection manuals 1, 2, and 3. Not only for the connection for the FRENIC inverters, of course, also for all the connectable devices. So let's go a bit in detail in the communication settings. So now I would like to show you how to set up these communication settings. First step is to create a new project in BSFT6. Then we have to select TechnoShot Smart as the HMI model. Then select inverter as connected device. Next is to select Fuji Electric as the maker. After that, select the FRENIC-Ace Modbus RTU driver as the model. And finally, select COM1, for example, as the communication port. Once the device, the driver, and the port are selected, a new window will appear automatically. In this window, it's possible to set up all the communication parameters, like connection mode, signal level, baud rate. You can find all the details, as I said before, in the connection manual. When programming the TechnoShot Smart, it is not necessary to know the Modbus addresses. The Modbus addresses which are linked to the FRENIC-Ace parameters. So, what we have in the BSFT software, it's available a table where we can find and select the right parameter by its name. This helps very much to save time when programming the HMI, because you don't have to know the for example, the parameter F1 is the Modbus address 40,100, I don't know. Okay, just knowing the parameters, we can program everything. We don't need to know the Modbus address. Okay, now it's time to take a look to the FRENIC-Ace communication parameter. As you have seen, the FRENIC-Ace has two serial ports, and we can choose any of them. So depending on the port, the set of parameters is different. For port 1, it's necessary to adjust parameters from Y1 to Y10. Then, in case of port 2, it's necessary to adjust parameters from Y11 to Y20. Also, we have three common parameters to adjust that are not related to the port. They are the Y98 for the bus function, the Y99 for the support link function, and the H30 for the link function. I don't want to go in detail in these parameters, so please refer to the connection manuals to check the details of these parameters. Okay, now all the necessary communication settings are ready. Let's see an example of how to read and write an inverter parameter. For example, we can do it with the F07, which is the acceleration time 1. So what we have to do in VS56? Then, once our program is ready, we have to insert a numerical display. Then we have to click over the contents icon. Then change the device from internal to PLC1, which is the FRENIC-Ace inverter. After that, as you can see, there is a small icon which looks like a calculator. So we have to click over this icon. A new window to select the parameter will appear. Then we have to click over the open switch. Another window with a complete parameter list appears. And here we have to select the desired parameter, and after that click over the select switch. Finally, click over the finish switch and the data display is ready to show or to write the value of the F07 parameter from the Ace inverter. Okay, next, component part of the FRENIC-Ace. Some of you might know the tools we call component parts. These are parts already made by Hako, and they are ready to use. Regarding the FRENIC-Ace component part, it is a complete keyboard with access to all the Ace parameters. So once the component part is placed in the screen, then it is possible to play with it, and I will show you how to do it. So first of all, click over the parameters switch. Then the parameter menu is displayed. And if we click, for example, over the F parameter switch and navigate through the F parameters. Then if we click over the menu switch, we come back to the parameters menu. Once we are again in this menu, we could choose another parameter group to see this group of parameters. Or if we want to come back, then we have to click over the operation panel switch in order to exit from this menu. This tool is very helpful, in my opinion, when the technical people is commissioning the inverters. This component part can help them to deal with the startup of the inverter, because we can access very fast to all the parameters and modify them and so on. I think it is faster than to check in the keypads of each inverter to set or to see or to check, modify or whatever in the keypads. I think it is, as I said, it is faster to do it in using the component parts.